The universe, with its scaring immensity, has awakened the thoughts of philosophers and poets since the early ages of humanity. For example, consider the multitude of Greek thinkers that discussed about the nature of space. Surprisingly, the possibility that something existed out from our galaxy, the Milky Way, just appeared in the 20s of the last century. Scientists discovered that nebulae, particular collections of ionized gas and stars, were positioned out from our galaxy. As a consequence, astronomers started to study the universe, which seemed to be older and bigger than what was thought before. At the same time, important discoveries were made about the age and the origin of the universe with the establishment of the foundation of the theory of Big Bang. This is probably one of the most intriguing theories ever elaborated by mankind. However, nothing in science is totally certain, and the same is valid for the theory of the birth and the evolution of our universe. As a matter of fact, a very rare and strange star, 200 light years distant from us, can unveil some big problems regarding our calculations. More precisely, recent measurements have shown that this shining object must have formed at least 200 million years before the Big Bang. How is this even possible? What methods can be used to estimate the age of a star? Are the calculations regarding the age of the universe incorrect? Or is it possible that something existed before the Big Bang? These and other questions are the main topic of this video. So if you are interested, stick with me and I'll tell you everything in a moment. As you can see, the themes we are dealing with are probably the most complicated and open problems of the entire physical research. As a consequence of that, we must proceed very slowly to understand what we are talking about. Firstly, what's the name of the star that claims to be older than the universe? HD 140283, also known as Methuselah Star. It is placed in the constellation of Libra, around 190 light years distant from us. The name is probably one of the most appropriate ones, because Methuselah was a Jewish prophet that is the oldest character depicted in the Bible, with the extraordinary age of 969 years. This star is what we can define as a sub-giant with very few metals in its composition. He was probably born in a dwarf galaxy that was successfully captured by our Milky Way. Another rare characteristic is its speed. Methuselah star travels at the enormous velocity of 1.3 million kilometers per hour towards our Earth. As a consequence of that, astronomers cataloged it in the list of high-velocity stars of our universe. How did the scientists understand this proper motion of HD 140283? They used the Doppler effect. Do you know what it is? If not, here's a simple explanation. When a light radiation source moves towards the observer, the wavelength is contracted and the frequency grows. The opposite happens if the source is receding from the observer. This effect is the same that makes the alarm of an ambulance change in frequency if it's reaching us or going away. Scientists exploit the Doppler effect to analyze the spectrum, catalog of the frequencies of light emitted by stars, of galaxies and stars. If some particular lines, called emission lines, are translated towards blue, greater wavelengths, it means that the star is moving towards the Earth. The most shocking characteristics of Methuselah is its age. Scientists tried to estimate it in 2000 and came out with the nonsense result of 16 billion years. Given the fact that the most recent measurements of the age of the universe establish a value of around 13.8 billion years, researchers tried to correct the first estimated age of the star with different methods. Between 2003 and 2011, further studies have been made on the parallax of the star with the fine guidance sensor of NASA's Hubble Space Telescope. But wait a moment, what is parallax? Parallax is probably the most famous method for measuring star distances. Practically, it is based on the displacement of the observed object related to a change of position of the observer. Does it seem difficult? Let's try to make a simple example. Try to position one finger near your face and observe it while closing the left eye. Now close the right one and watch the finger with the left. Have you noticed something? The finger has slightly changed position. Why does that happen? Because we are observing the object from a different point in space. The same effect can be observed with stars. Their coordinates in space undergo some small changes as the Earth orbits around the Sun. These studies were really important to estimate more rigorously the age of the star together with another main indicator, oxygen. In the majority of observed stars, oxygen is not so abundant, but in HD 140283, the rate of this element relatively to other atoms is particularly high. This fact, together with parallax and other parameters such as emission from radioactive elements present in the star, made possible to establish the age of Methuselah around 14.46 billion years. Surely this new estimate is better than the previous one, but it's in conflict with the age of the universe calculated by the Planck satellite in 2015, which has been said to be nearly 13.8 billion years. Further research has been made in 2014, and the age of the star has been elaborated as 14.27 billion years. However, if we consider the margin of error provided by this study, Methuselah must definitely be at least 14 billion years old, which is still 200 million years older than the universe. How is this possible? Maybe we should consider the hypothesis that something existed before the Big Bang. Before finding out more about this, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel, clicking the bell so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Although these questions might seem very interesting, it's not possible to give a proper answer in a few minutes. And so we'll just try to understand the main hypothesis regarding this problem. The most important thing scientists need to know is the exact measurement of the age of the universe. Although the value elaborated by the Planck observations is really precise, it's definitely not sure if the assumptions made to calculate the number of 13.8 billion years are totally correct. How can we estimate the age of the universe? The first method is through abundances of radioactive elements. Some particular heavy elements, like uranium, have a large number of protons and neutrons in their nucleus and tend not to be so stable. As a result, they usually decay, emitting different types of radiation like alpha particles. The rate of decay follows a negative exponential law. Moreover, various types of uranium exist, called isotopes. They differ just for the number of neutrons. For example, uranium-235 has 235 neutrons, and uranium-238, 238. The first isotope has a shorter decay than the other one. Consequently, uranium-238 is relatively more and more abundant today, even if the two isotopes were present almost in the same quantity in the early universe. The measurement of the ratio between the two now and in the past naturally gives us an estimated age of the universe of 10 billion years. In order to be more precise, other methods have been developed. The main one is linked to the Hubble constant. Do you know who Edwin Hubble is? He's very famous for Hubble's law, discovered by Edwin Hubble in 1929. It's one of the most famous laws of astronomy. It states that the faster a star or galaxy recedes from us, the greater its distance. Distance and velocity have a linear relation through a constant called Hubble's constant that was initially calculated with a very low precision by the astronomer. He was able to underline this correlation by measuring the red shift, the displacement of absorption lines in stellar spectrum caused by the Doppler effect we previously mentioned. Further research has been made after this discovery, and today we know that this redshift in the light coming from distant galaxies is caused by the expansion of space itself. The Earth and galaxy are standing still on a space-time, if we want to be precise, that is expanding with a positive acceleration. As a result of that, the two objects seem to be further from each other with the passing of time. Why is this linked to the age of the universe? Well, if we think of the Big Bang as an event in which all galaxies are here in the same point, then the age of the universe is the inverse of the Hubble constant, which is around 14 billion years. Furthermore, a major topic in cosmology, which is the study of the birth, development, and death of our universe, are the Friedmann equations. It's very difficult to make a rigorous derivation of these laws, so we can't simply assume that they're a result of general relativity, and they can be even found in a simplified way by using just the Newtonian dynamic principles. The first one shows that the velocity, which is the change of the scale factor, the size of space, is linked to the density and the curvature of our universe. The second Friedman equation deals with the acceleration of the universe that results to be always negative. Consequently, the rate of expansion or contraction is slowing down with time. However, at the end of the last century, we discovered that the expansion is accelerating and some changes were made regarding these laws. Finally, the third law, also known as fluid equations, describes the correlation among the change of the density, the pressure of radiation, and the scale factor R. The first one favors a contraction, because matter has a strong gravitational force that tends to gather everything together, as the Sun does with our planets. On the other hand, the pressure of radiation enables a possible expansion. What is pressure of radiation? The universe is filled with electromagnetic radiation, like light, X-rays, gamma rays, infrared, and other types, that has the ability to warm objects. We experience this when we take sun at the beach, for example, but even to have a small pressure on things similar to that of wind. But why are these equations important to solve our problem? Basing on the curvature of space-time and on some parameters like the average density of matter, they predict the age of the universe as 13 to 14 billion years. But this is not the end. As I mentioned before, Planck in 2015 managed to come up with a more precise value of 13.8 billion years. How is it possible? This experiment studied the so-called cosmic microwave background, or relic radiation. What is it? It's a radiation that fills the entire space and has the wavelength of microwaves, resembling the emission of a body, a black body for the experts, and 2.73K. What is the origin of this radiation? It's the first emission of photons of history. In the previous stages of time after the Big Bang, the temperature and the density were so high that atoms couldn't form, and light, photons, were trapped in a lot of collisions with the particles. However, when the universe cooled down, the photons were able to travel on a straight line, and they are constantly arriving on Earth from every direction now. This study of the relic radiation furnishes important proof of the age of the universe. But is it possible that all these precise measurements are wrong? Yes, nothing is certain. Why? Because the calculations are made based on a lot of different parameters, and one of them is still a big mystery for scientists. What is it? The cosmological parameter. Practically, it's like a correction of the Friedman equations based on the evidence that the majority of our universe is composed by an unknown dark energy that makes space expand at an accelerated rate. Physicists have always thought that the influence of dark matter has been constant throughout the development of the universe, but observations seem to not correspond to this assumption. Consequently, something interacting with dark matter must make our universe really unstable, expanding at different rates in different ages. Some theoretical research has predicted the existence of a particle called axion that could influence dark matter, but no experimental evidence has been found. As a consequence of this change in the expansion rate, probably even time might have flowed at different rates in the history of our universe. As a result of that, it can be really difficult to estimate the age at which everything formed. To sum up, Methuselah has still formed at least 200 million years before the universe. But further discoveries on dark matter, the expansion rate, and interacting particles will try to unveil the mystery of the oldest observed star. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. Did you find this topic exciting? Are you amazed by the different methods used to calculate the age of the universe? Do you think that it's possible that something existed before the Big Bang? Is there anything more you want to hear about Methuselah, the oldest star in the universe? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.